How does the Windows Runtime manage to build new APIs without breaking existing ones? Well, the lovely thing about building the Windows Runtime was that we were starting from scratch. So we had the opportunity to learn all the lessons that the Windows team had learned over the years, and we were also building our infrastructure, our APIs, on top of COM. And it turns out that when you use COM as your underpinning, you get this thing called IUnknown. And it turns out that IUnknown gives you a really lovely mechanism for versioning. When we were designing the API surface, we knew that we wanted to expose our APIs as classes and not as like interfaces or flat APIs. We wanted to give an object-oriented experience. And so we created this concept called a runtime class. And a runtime class is really, at the end of the day, just a COM object. And it has an interface. And it turns out if you want to add a new API or new APIs to your COM object, well, that's actually not too hard. You create a new interface with a new interface ID, and you query interface using the COM APIs. You query interface for the new interface. And that allows you to add more and more and more and more and more APIs to a single class over the course of many years. And now you have the ability to add new APIs, to add new functionality to existing classes without ever having to worry about breaking the old ones, because the API contract that the old APIs used, that API contract is still going to work, and it's going to work basically forever because, well, the API you used to call is still the API you're calling today.